पूज्य स्वामी जी एंड फ्रेंड्स, आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू दिस इवनिंग टू द लेक्चर बाय स्वामी निखिलेश्वरानंद जी ऑन वैल्यूज ऑफ वैल्यू इन लाइफ. टुडे इट हैज बिकम वेरी इम्परेटिव एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट इन अवर डे टू डे लाइफ दैट वी इम्बाइब values in our life. Incidentally, friends, today Anna Hazare is in town, and you all know that he has started a crusade against corruption, and in many areas India is developing, but in the level of corruption and integrity, as you may have been reading in the newspaper, we are much, much below. And it's a shame to the society at large, as many institutions today we hear day in, day out, that yes, someone is caught red-handed, ACB has captured him, like that. All these things have adversely affected our image globally, and also equally our developments in various fields. For introduction purpose, though Swamiji is known to most of you, but there may be few of those who may not have occasion to listen to him, I'll just briefly say few words about him. Sri Nikhileshwaranand ji is the head of Vadodara Center of Ramakrishna Mission, which is started by Swami Vivekananda more than 100 years before. This mission has 165 branches all over the world. He is a, friends, I can say that he is a chemical engineer, and then naturally an engineer becoming a saint, a Swamiji, is normally not usual. And he has also done industrial engineering in 1972, and with a short time of as a management consultant, he renounced this world and joined Ramakrishna Mission at the headquarter at Belur Math in 1976. Yet for 11 years he edited Gujarati monthly Sri Ramakrishna Jyot, published from Ramakrishna Ashram, Rajkot. He has toured extensively preaching the universal message of Vedanta in industrial houses, management institutions, and educational institutions too. He has conducted training programs on stress management, productivity through holistic management, management of mind, total personality development, women empowerment, etc., and many more such related subjects. He has visited many countries for preaching the universal message of Vedanta, like South Africa, Mauritius, Germany, France, Netherlands, Switzerland. And he just mentioned to me that he has recently returned from USA with a highly successful visit, and so many CDs of his lectures are purchased by Indian Americans and others in America. And friends, we have a stall down below that you can also have the privilege to purchase the CDs, which you can listen to at your convenience, while traveling or at your residence, and you will immensely benefit from his wisdom and knowledge. Please welcome Swamiji. And my last request would be, I will start doing that, please switch off our mobiles so that he is not disturbed during his lecture. Thank you all. Please, I would like to welcome Swamiji on behalf of all of you in AMA with a bouquet of flowers.
ॐ असतो मा सद्गमय, तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय, मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमय। ॐ शान्तिः शान्तिः शान्तिः। डियर फ्रेंड्स, इट्स अ ग्रेट प्लेजर मीटिंग यू ऑल दिस इवनिंग. In fact, I was thinking that there will be very few people today here in this hall, but the hall is full. That is very strange, because I thought that all would be there. There is a parallel program I heard of Anna Hazare, so I thought there will be very few people, but all of you have come in a very large number. It's always a pleasure to talk to the enlightened audience of AMA. I have been coming here for last many few years, speaking on various topics. Today's topic is value of values in life. You know, there is an Austrian philosopher. Of course, he afterwards went to Britain. He says about values, values a terrible business. You can at best stammer when you talk about them. You can at best stammer when you talk about them. Values is such a word. It's a very, very difficult word which has got various meanings to various people. It's a relative word. But we will not go into the complex meanings. It has got a lot of meaning. I will not go into the technical. I will try to make my presentation very simple, non-technical, and in day-to-day life, what do we mean? Normally, value has got a very different connotations in different fields. It's a relative word. But normally, when we say values in life, means moral and spiritual values. This is a common man's view. Though values will mean to a sportsman also, there is value to a scientists also, their values in various fields. Values will mean sometimes ethos, sometimes it may mean the rules, regulations, laws, so many things. But then let us for the time being, I would like to concentrate on moral and spiritual values. Now, when we talk about moral and spiritual values, the question arises, is it feasible to practice these values in the present scenario, particularly in India? Second, faydo shu thase? We are in Gujarat. The first question when you put any proposal is, faydo shu thase? Faydo. What is the benefit? Is it feasible? Second, faydo shu thase? What is the benefit? What are the advantages? So we must know the value of values in life. That is why this subject has been kept. Is there any value? Gold has value. Even if it is told, supposing it is announced by AMA, that today there will be no lecture, only 14 carat gold will be distributed. See how many people will come. Gold is more valuable. Gold is more valuable. But supposing if you are put into an island with lot of gold, nothing else, nothing to eat, nothing to drink, how many days can you survive? Lot of gold. You know the story. A king was very much enamored by gold, and so one day he was given a boon by a god, a Greek god. So he said, what do you want? I want gold and gold only. Okay, the boon was that whatever you touch will become gold. And he became so happy. He started immediately touching his cot, became gold. Then immediately started touching his throne, gold. Everything went on touching and it all became gold and he was so happy. Then after touching so many things, everything has become gold and he was so happy. But after all, after so much of efforts, he became hungry. So he sat down on his dining table and the plate was brought. The plate became gold. He was very happy. Then the chapati was brought. That also became gold. Now he can't eat that one. So he was miserable. Everything is becoming gold. He can't eat and he is becoming hungry. And he did not love anybody in the whole world and did not love anything except gold in the whole world. But he loved his daughter. He had a beautiful daughter. He loved her. So his daughter came, seeing his plight, and then he became miserable that I am not able to eat. So the daughter went to him and hugged him, and she became gold. Now you can imagine, golden girl with a golden plate, with golden chapatis, it's all gold. So what is the intrinsic value of gold? Imagine, what is intrinsic? All of us sitting here, we have got some equation in our mind that H is directly proportional to M, where H is equal to happiness and M is equal to money. You know, we are talking about this corruption and all that. I did not put the word corruption because it has got a political flavor. So I wanted to avoid the word, but I want... Yeah, there is space here. There is space here in front. Please come, all of you. Wherever you find space, you can come, no problem. So, I wanted to avoid the word because as a monk of Ramakrishna Mission, we want to be away from politics as per the rules framed by Swami Vivekananda. So, it has got a little connotation of politics. I wanted to avoid the word. But corruption is in the air. Everywhere they are talking about corruption. And today it's a coincidence that Anna Hazare is here and people were asking me what do you think about Anna Hazare and his proposition and all that. So without going to politics, I will say yes, we appreciate his efforts. In fact, I would like to share a story. A young man was sitting on a bench in a railway platform at Delhi railway station. It was night time. He took out his pen and paper, wrote down in his diary, "Nobody is responsible for my suicide." Put the diary on his pocket and he was waiting for a train so that he can jump and end his life. Suddenly he remembered his sister was to get married after a few months. And he thought if he commits a suicide, then his sister would suffer. So he said, "No, okay, I'll commit suicide after the marriage of my sister," and he was saved. Next day morning, he went to the station bookstall. There he saw a photograph, beautiful photograph of Swami Vivekananda. He was very much attracted. So he said, "I want a photograph." The bookseller said, "It is not a photograph, it is a small book with the cover page showing photograph of Swami Vivekananda." He was not interested in reading any book, but anyway, he liked the photographs, he purchased the book. Since he purchased the book, he started reading. As soon as he read the book, he said, "I don't want to commit suicide." He decided. Why he was committing suicide? Because he did not find purpose in life. Not that he was any frustration. Not that he had any problem in life. No. Only thing is, did not find any purpose in life. He was working in Indian Army as a truck driver. In 1965, there was war with Pakistan. And when he was driving the vehicle, suddenly he found an aeroplane descending. They thought it is an Indian plane, but it turned out to be a Pakistan plane, and immediately it bombed. And all his 19 colleagues died on the spot. He survived, but he got seriously injured. Somehow, he crept into the camp, military camp, and then he was transferred to Delhi Hospital. He survived. But he lost all his interest in life. Why are we alive? Just for meeting death? Just for ending up in death? And he saw his own colleagues dying. So what is the purpose of life? Just for dying? I don't want to live. There is no purpose in life. But when he read the book of Swami Vivekananda, what is the purpose of life? Swami Vivekananda wrote to the Maharaja of Mysore, beautiful letter, where he says, "My dear prince, this life is short. The vanities of this world are transient. In this short life, they alone live who live for others. The rest are more dead than alive." He said, "No, I don't want to be dead. I want to be alive in the real sense of the term. And I will sacrifice my life for serving others." Where Swamiji says, unselfishness is morality. Selfishness is immorality. What a beautiful definition. The whole gamut of the scripture, so many scriptures in so many religions, of so many countries, they are talking about values. And if you go through that literature, it will take years together to study them. But Swami Vivekananda gives the gist of the whole of this thing. What is the value? Unselfishness is the test of religion. Unselfishness is the test of values. Unselfishness is morality, and selfishness is immorality. In one word, he has compressed the whole gamut, the whole concept of values. So he became enamored. He immediately took premature retirement from the Indian Army, got 65,000 rupees as pension, went to his village in Maharashtra, and first he started repairing the temple that was there, which was in bad shape. He repaired the temple. He started educating the children there and the masses there in the villages, and he got the groups of young people, stopped all the liquor outlets for which he had to pay a very heavy price. But he stood firm. Gradually, because of the education that he provided through the temple as a focal point, gradually values, other values, they started coming. The liquor shops were closed. He started water harvest project. And with all those things, within 3 years, that village became an ideal village. And the Maharashtra government was so much impressed that it gave lot of other money to that person to bring out the transformation in other villages. That is how the whole transformation started. Later on, he got Padma Shri, Padma Vibhushan. You know the name of that person, Anna Hazare. The name of the village is Ralegaon Siddhi. And now today he's in Ahmedabad. Parallel meeting. This is how his life was saved. This is the background. He derives inspiration from the message of Swami Vivekananda. So naturally, I read this thing many years back. I was, at the time, I was the editor of our Gujarati monthly Ramakrishna Jyot. So I asked for his permission to publish this account in our magazine. He wrote to me also, and he gave the permission. Not only that, then again, there was an article in the centenary, during the centenary, Ramakrishna Mission, you know, was started in 1897. So 1997, we had a centenary celebration of Ramakrishna Mission. So a big volume was brought out. History and the story of Ramakrishna Mission, there my article was there, a survey of Ramakrishna Vivekananda literature, where I gave that story with this permission. So that I have been telling about this story for last 20 years. In fact, when I gave a talk here at AMA about 5-6 years back, happiness and peace in everyday life, I had told about this incident. It's incidentally today he is here on this day. I never knew, because my program was fixed 3 months back. This program was fixed about 3 months back. It's just coincidence that he is here. And he is working very hard. What I appreciate about him is that he has been doing very silent work in the villages. And he means whatever he says, he means it. And his life is very ennobling. And life, and that is what Swami Vivekananda had given the formula. For when we talk about values in life, he gave a beautiful formula. Be and make. First you become great, then make others great. First you build your own character, then make others great. First you follow the values, then make others follow the values. Without that, you just preaching values is of no use. And so he says, 1 ounce of practice is more important than 1 ton of preaching, which he has practiced and he's practicing. Now, that is one part of it. Second part, his association with the political party, this and that, and his statements, some of the statements on political, I do not have much knowledge, nor do I venture into that. But one thing is that his life is good as it appeared to me, and he is trying to do good to the society in whatever way. As far as he has taken up a crusade and he taken up a crusade for the Lokpal Bill and all that, very good, there are very good attempts. But will it solve the problem? This is what we have to see. Supposing whatever he proposes is taken up by the government, and now that Lokpal Bill is also, supposing in the manner in which he wants, is passed, will it stop corruption? Will it stop corruption? Swami Vivekananda wanted that India should rise. India is rising also. So we have two types of India at present in our country, two India. One India rising, science and technology, engineering, biotechnology, genetic engineering, and economically becoming a giant, economic giant, everything. There's one India rising on the economic, on the international market. Second India, 22% below poverty line, minimum. Minimum 22% below poverty line, 35% illiterates, and a lot of malnutrition. And most important is, according to Transparency International, there are 10 great countries having highest rate of corruption, and one of them is Mera Bharat Mahan. So this is the second type of India. These two are coexisting. Why it is happening? This is exactly what I pointed out to Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. On 16th April 2003, I was at Rashtrapati Bhavan talking to Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. I had gone there to gift him the CD that we had prepared based on the very inspiring speech that he had delivered at Porbandar. At the time I was in Porbandar, talking to 3,000 youth. He had come there to inaugurate one of the school buildings constructed by us as a part of earthquake rehabilitation project. We constructed 81 school buildings, axis colonies, as a part of earthquake rehabilitation project. One of the schools was inaugurated by him, and then he talked to 3,000 people. At that time, they asked the question, what is the source of inspiration? So Dr. Kalam said, normally I do not leak out this secret, but this is the right place to leak out this secret. And then he said, I was the monitor of my school, and my principal, I was in 8th standard, and my principal told that you bring all the children together today, tonight, night or 12 o'clock, they should listen to the running commentary. No TV at that time. 15th August 1947. India will become independent and there is a running commentary, all the children should listen. So he said, I brought all the children and we were very happy to listen to the running commentary. Of course, at that time we did not know anything but Tamil, and we neither knew English nor Hindi, but we were very happy that India has become independent. Then he said, second day in the newspapers, I saw a photograph, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru hoisting the Indian flag on the Red Fort building. And we were very happy. Then Dr. Kalam said, by the side was the second photograph. And that photograph was my primary education, was my second education, was my college education, and was my life education. And what was that photograph? That photograph was showing that when Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was hoisting the Indian flag, and when the whole country was rejoicing over the freedom that they had gained, at that time, one person who made this possible singularly with his greatest amount of sacrifice, the one person who made this freedom possible, he was not rejoicing. He was walking barefooted in the streets of Calcutta, wiping the tears of the people who had been affected by Nawakhole riots, Mahatma Gandhi. Then he said, I could understand what is the nobility of leadership. The real leaders, they sacrifice. While sacrificing, they are ahead. And while receiving the award or reward or the benefits, they are the last. Unlike the modern day leaders, for sacrificing, they are the last. For getting the chair, first. That is why Swami Vivekananda said, what is the secret of leadership? He said, Sirdar, Vahi Sardar. Jo sir de sakta hai, wahi sardar ban sakta hai. One who can sacrifice his head, one who can sacrifice his ego, one who can sacrifice his selfishness, one who can make sacrifice, he only can be the true leader which will work for the long time. I'm going to talk about that Swami Vivekananda ideas on leadership and how he was the real leader how that all those ideas that he gave was were translated into his own life. I'm going to talk tomorrow. But this is what Dr. Kalam said. I was very much impressed in the nobility of leadership. It's a very beautiful speech he had given. And he had meditated in the room in which Swami Vivekananda stayed in Porbandar. And he wrote also in his book, Ignited Minds, that sitting in that room in Porbandar, I was lost in meditation. He did not use the word samadhi, but really he was in samadhi. We had to bring him out, and because it was getting late. He's a pure mind, so wherever good vibrations are there, Swami Vivekananda was there. Again in Baroda when he came 30th March 2008, same thing. That time he was getting late, so I did not want to repeat the story of Porbandar, so I did not make him sit at all. But standing itself, he went into samadhi. And then afterwards we had to, because it was a very short time for him. But whatever it is. So we had made a CD out of that, and so I went to Delhi, Rashtrapati Bhavan. I was going to Delhi for some other purpose. I thought, why not I personally give him the CD rather than sending it. And I wanted 5 minutes, but he gave 15 minutes. And then we had a lot of talks. I said, Dr. Kalam, I'm very happy that you want to make India a developed country by 2020. You know, he has written a book, India 2020, the Vision of the New Millennium. And I'm very happy that you are working so hard. You have brought out the plans and programs. You are talking to the youth, selling your vision. To tell you frankly, we also, the monks of Ramakrishna Mission, are also trying in our own way to make India great, because it was the dream of Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda said, India will become so great that its past glory will fade into insignificance. That is what Swami Vivekananda had said. So we are trying to bring out this vision. In fact, he was very much impressed when he said, what is this? Is it really the fact? I said, yes, it is a fact. That Swami Vivekananda one day was sitting, suddenly he said, I have seen. What you have seen? His brother disappeared. He said, after meditation, he said, I have seen next 1500 years of history of our country. What did you see? I saw that India has become great. It has become so great that its past glory will fade into insignificance. He became very much interested. Can you tell me the incident? Yes, I gave him the book. In this book it is written. This is the well-documented book, his biography. So he was very happy. He said, we also are trying to translate his dream into action, that is making India great. But we have taken a different path. But I can tell you one thing. Even if you bring the wealth of the whole World Bank, the poverty of the poor people will not go. He became very much, why Swamiji, why? I said, even if you increase the GDP growth, I am talking about 2003, 16th April. That time GDP growth was 9.5%. We had 9.5%, and yet the 22% below poverty. By 2003, I was talking to him that even if you increase GDP growth, the poverty of the poor people will not go. Why, Swamiji, why? I said, for the simple reason, the former Prime Minister said, if you put 1 rupee in the 5-year plan, only 15 paisa comes to the grassroots level farmer. I am afraid even 5 paisa is coming or not. Right from the beginning, from minister down to the officers and secretary and the joint secretary and the deputy secretary and the BDO and DDO and BDO and Kamchari, by the time it comes, it is hardly 5 paisa, and by the time the farmer has committed suicide. It's such a long time. So many nice projects are there. And I told Dr. Kalam, I am now talking about newspaper reports. I got first-hand information. I was for 10 years in Bihar. Now it has become Jharkhand. I was in Ranchi. We have Divyan Krishi Vigyan Kendra, it is considered as the best Krishi Vigyan Kendra of the whole country. It is a tribal development project that we are running there. So I was there for 10 years. So it's such a huge project, so naturally, I had to go to Patna. That time Patna was the capital for some work, for a land problem, this, that problem. And they used to call me Sukha Party. Sukha Party, dry party, because I will never give any bribe. And they say in Bihar, at that time I'm talking about that Bihar, I do not know. I heard the situation is changing, that's very good, but I do not know presently. But that time it was really considered as the king of all corruptions in the whole state. Bihar state was leading in corruption. So it was specialized. So they said, you are here, you know, we do not talk. In fact, one of our Swamijis went there to meet one secretary revenue, somebody. So the peon said, Chitti laya, बोले हाँ चिट्ठी लाया, किसका चिट्ठी है? बोले चीफ सेक्रेटरी का चिट्ठी। वो चिट्ठी नहीं चलता है, जहा साहब का चिट्ठी चाहिए। ही कुड नॉट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज जहा साहब। बाद में पता पड़ा के जहा का सिग्नेचर रहता है ना, वो कैश चाहिए, कैश रुपया। पहले कैश रुपया दो, बाद में जाने देगा भीतर। ये जहा साहब का चिट्ठी हमको पता ही नहीं था पहले। जहा साहब का चिट्ठी चाहिए, के जहा वॉज द गवर्नर जनरल ऑफ रिजर्व बैंक, सो ही सिग्नेचर इज ऑन अ नोट, दैट नोट, दैट चिट्ठी चाहिए। ऐसा बाकी चिट्ठी यहां काम नहीं करता। चीफ सेक्रेटरी का चिट्ठी का कोई मीनिंग नहीं। पहले चिट्ठी चाहिए, जहा साहब का चिट्ठी। दिस इज द फर्स्ट एंड एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ आवर स्वामी, एंड आई वॉज देयर, आई सॉ विथ माई ओन, आई टोल्ड डॉक्टर कलाम, आई सॉ विथ माई ओन आईज, आई हैड टू मीट द प्रिंसिपल सेक्रेटरी ऑफ द चीफ मिनिस्टर। ऑन द टेबल देर वॉज ए चार्ट, टाइप चार्ट फॉर ट्रांसफर 5 lakh, फॉर न्यू पोस्टिंग 7 lakh, एवरीथिंग इज रिटन देयर, देर इज एब्सोल्युटली नो डिसीविंग, नो फ्रॉड, एवरीथिंग इज रिटन एंड स्टैंडर्ड रेट, सो यू डोंट हैव टू वेस्ट योर टाइम इन बार्गेनिंग। यू सी, जस्ट गिव 7 lakh रुपीज, नो बार्गेनिंग, स्टैंडर्ड रेट्स, एवरीथिंग इज सो मेटिकुलसली डन, जस्ट गिव 7 lakh रुपीज, जस्ट गिव 5 lakh रुपीज फ्रॉम अंडर द टेबल कैश, एंड नेक्स्ट डे विद इन 24 hours यू गेट द ट्रांसफर ऑर्डर। द मोस्ट इफिशियंट गवर्नमेंट इन द होल वर्ल्ड, यू कांट गेट, यू कांट गेट विद इन 24 hours। कैन यू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ मेनी प्लेसेस दिस हैज टू गो, बिकॉज वी हैव इनहेरिटेड द ब्रिटिश स्टाइल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट इन अवर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, सो दैट फाइल हैज टू मूव 200 प्लेसेस, दैट फाइल विल बी मूविंग एट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक स्पीड, सुपरसोनिक स्पीड। It will go from one place, another place, the signature, and the principal secretary goes in the helicopter with the chief minister to get the signatures on those 200 files for which cash has been received. Next day, 24 hours, within 20, you get the transfer order. This I have seen with my own eyes. I told Dr. Kalam, I am not talking from papers. I have seen the rampant corruption and every step. Because we are also working, we are in the working society. Swami Vivekananda said, I don't want you to become the olden types of monks. We have thousands of such monks. I want my monks in Ramakrishna Mission to be modern monks who will be living in the society, working for the society, for the people. At the same time, they will be following the old concept of Atmano Mokshartham. So he gave a new mantra. We don't want Atmano Mokshartham. What we want is Atmano Mokshartham Jagadhitaya cha. Serving every human being as a manifestation of the divinity. He said, for thousands of years we have taken bhiksha from this society. They have given us bhiksha. Today the whole society is in very bad shape. Is it not your duty to come forward to do something for the society? Not only that, you are talking about God. What, after all, what you want? You want to worship God. How? By doing pran pratishta in the image. Here they are living human beings. Already pran pratishta is there. Why do you want to do pran pratishta there in the image? Here is the veritable representative of God. And so he said, so long you had heard the mantra, Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava, Atithi Devo Bhava. I am giving you some new mantras. What is that? Daridra Devo Bhava, Rogi Devo Bhava. Worship Daridra Narayana. Vinoba Bhave says, Mahatma Gandhi popularized this word Daridra Narayana, but it was invented by Swami Vivekananda. Later on, Gandhiji made it popular, Daridra Narayana. Rogi Narayan, worship the God in sick, worship the God in poor. And that is why Ramakrishna Mission, we tell, forgetting the Atmano Mokshartham is the goal of life for every human being. Of course, we must have salvation, we must have perfection. Manifestation of the divinity is the goal of life, for which 4 yogas are there: Raja Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Jnana Yoga, and Karma Yoga. But supreme is Karma Yoga for the time, for the modern age. We have to serve the humanity, because it serves double purpose. The person whom you serve gets chapati and you get salvation. The person whom you serve gets medicine, gets treated, and you get salvation. So a double advantage. That is why Swami Vivekananda says, for the modern age, what we want is Seva Yoga or Karma Yoga. And that is why in Ramakrishna Mission you will find that though we are also having morning, evening meditation, morning, evening prayers, morning, evening reading and all that, but most of the time we are trying to serve the society in various ways. We have 20 indoor hospitals, 90 outdoor hospitals, and 60 mobile dispensaries, to one 1 crore of patients are getting treatment free of cost, so many eye camps. Then 6,000 education institutions where 6 lakh students are studying, where we try to give them man-making, character-building education, as told by Swami Vivekananda, like that. Then tribal or rural development projects, and all those projects are not social service we are not doing. That is worshiping the God in man. So that is what Swami Vivekananda started, this Atmano Mokshartham Jagad Hitayacho. That is the ideal for which he started Ramakrishna Mission. So I told Dr. Kalam that we are trying to bring out this vision of Swamiji through this service to mankind, and more importantly, spreading the ideas, particularly in the field of education. So I told Dr. Kalam, even if you bring the wealth of the whole World Bank, the poverty of the poor people will not go. Why? I said, for the rampant corruption in the country today. I told in 2003, what is the solution, Swamiji? I said, only one solution. What is that? What we should around 15th August 1947, we should do it now. What is that? Swami Vivekananda said, education alone is the panacea of all our evils. But what type of education? Not the present system of education. Swami Vivekananda said, what we want is man-making education, character-building education. And I jokingly said, what we are giving is Rakshasa-making education, demon-making education. What is a demon? What is a Rakshasa? Rakshasa does not mean with two horns as you see in the TV programs, no. This modern Rakshasa coming in safari suit, modern Rakshasa coming with Banarasi sari, latest dress. What is Rakshasa and Rakshasi? This modern Rakshasa and Rakshasi? So, Bharti says in his book Niti Shatakam, there are four types of people in the society. What are the four types? Eke Satpurushah Parartha Ghatakah Swarthan Parityajyaye Samanyastu Paratham Udyam Abrata Swartha Avirodhenaye Temi Manav Rakshasah Parahitam Swarthay Nignantiye Ye Dnanti Nirarthakam Parahitam Teke न जानी मह. Four types of people are in the society. Number one, Satpurusha, excellent human beings. They try to do good to others, sacrificing their own lives. Excellent human beings. Satpurusha. Second, Samanya Manushya, ordinary human beings. They first try to do good to themselves and then they try to do good to others. Third, Manav Rakshasa. They're looking like human beings, but they are Rakshasa in human form. Demons. What do they do? For their small self-interest, they can do any amount of harm to others. Example, plenty. An executive engineer takes 10 lakhs of rupees of bribe from under the table, not from above the table. And tells the builder, you can mix any amount of sand with cement, I don't mind, but you give me 10 lakhs of rupees. And the builder, while constructing a check dam for the government, he uses only sand, very little cement. With the result, there is heavy rain, and the check dam gets burst, thousands of people become homeless, hundreds of people die, crores of rupees of loss to the nation, but that executive engineer is smiling. Don't worry, I got 10 lakh rupees, mera makan ban gaya, desh jaye bhaad mein, samaj jaye bhaad mein. I have got my house with 10 lakh rupees, let the nation go to hell, let the people go to hell. Now, this type of engineers, and they are in every field, doctors, engineers, chartered accountants, teachers, all, I don't see any field where we don't have Manav Rakshasa. They are penetrating every life, but I did not give example, you know better than me. Manav Rakshasa, these are all Rakshasa in human form. And then Bhartri says, there are four type of people also, but I can't give the name. Te ke na jani mahe. I can tell you what type of people they are, because Manav Rakshasa, these people are worse than Manav Rakshasa. Manav Rakshasa, they try to do good, they try to do harm others for their small self-interest, for their small good. But the four type of people, they do not derive any benefit, but they enjoy others' downfall and others' harm. Somebody's house is burning on fire. Oh, very nice. Uska ghar makan mein jal gaya, bahut acha hua. They are so happy. But did you get any benefit? No, but I am so happy his house is burning. Somebody gets demoted, I am very happy. Somebody is failed in the exam, I am so happy. But did you get one mark extra? No, but I am so happy. So these four type of people, they enjoy others' downfall and others' harm without any benefit to themselves. They are worse than Manav Rakshasa. These are the four types of people about whom Bhartari said in his book Niti Shatakam. And I have made a letter, sister, there is a fifth type also. Maybe they were not at the time of Bhartari, so he did not mention it. Maybe they are new products. Now, I can't give the name, you see. I can't give the name. Te ke na janim hai. If four type of people, no names, of fifth type people, te ke na janim. But I tell you what to people. Four type people, they do not get any benefit, but they enjoy others' downfall, others' harm. But the fifth type people, they get so much happiness in harming others. By harming themselves, they do harm to others. So they sit down in aeroplane, strike with the world tower. I am dead, doesn't matter. But 3,000 people died. I am so happy. And you must have heard about the story of the conch shell, Shankh Wali Kahani. The person got a boon and then he got a conch shell, and by worshiping the conch shell, he will get whatever he wants. And so his wife worshipped, and so immediately he got a beautiful house. But the boon was like that, whatever he gets, for asking, neighbor will get without asking double of that. So when he came back and he was amazed, and the wife was so happy that, you know, we have got beautiful house and beautiful dress and beautiful food. Please take food. But he was started weeping. Why you are weeping? Why are you not happy? You mad person, you do not know this. You see the other side, that neighbor has got two beautiful houses. How can I take food? No, I can't take food. He became so miserable. What? I brought the conch shell. I got the boon. And the benefit is got by that neighbor with whom I am quarreling every day. I cannot see this. This is becomes too much for me. And so he became so much perturbed. Whole night he was weeping. I got the conch shell and he got the benefit. I got the conch shell, he got the benefit. So ultimately he became so much unhappy that in the morning he again started worshipping the conch shell. And then the conch shell, the god of conch shell appeared. What do you want? He said, if you are really blessing me, then do one thing, let there be one well before my house. So there were two wells before the houses of the neighbor. And then he said, let me become blind with one eye. And so the neighbor became blind with both the eyes, and he fell down into the well, and then he died. And he was so happy. I have become blind, but the fellow died. So these are the fifth type of people. By harming themselves, they do harm to others. They are so happy in harming others. By harming themselves, they do harm to others. So you will find such jealous people. Even if they get little demoted, doesn't matter. But I will see to that person gets out of the job. Let me see. How does he survive? So they are so much full of jealousy and full of enmity feeling that by harming themselves, they do harm to others. These are the fifth type. And so you will find in the society today, we have Manav Rakshasa plenty. Four type also and fifth type also. Samana Manushya, ordinary human beings are also there, but few. And Satpurusha, we have to see with the microscope. Microscope minority, but they are there. Not that they are not, but you have to see with the microscope. In a microscopic minority compared to that. That is why Swami Vivekananda said, what we want is man-making education, character-building education. So I told, this is the solution. We should have done it on 15th August 1947. Government of India should have started this man-making character-building education. And Swami Vivekananda said, before flooding India with political ideas, flood the country with spiritual ideas. India has got specialization. Every country has got specialization. India's contribution has been the contribution of spiritual culture to the whole world. If India becomes weak in spiritual culture, it will get destroyed. In three generations, you will be extinct. He gave a warning. And this is exactly what we did. We purposely started having an education system which will be bereft of spiritual culture. Dr. Radhakrishnan Committee, Dr. Kothari Commission, every committee they told, immediately implement this spiritual education. Bring spiritual education in the country. Bring character building education in the country. Otherwise, this is going to spoil. But we did not listen, and today, this is what has happened. It was to happen. Because our children have been never given those values. In the name of pseudo-secularism, secularism is very good, but pseudo-secularism is bad. In the name of pseudo-secularism, we removed all the values. You see, there are two ways of helping a person. What we did was, one person, he was a blacksmith. He was working with full concentration. He had a son. He was very intelligent, extraordinarily intelligent. That ekdam buddhu. So he told, you see, I am now working, and if any fly comes, please see to it that the fly, remove the fly. He said, don't worry. So he saw a fly sitting on the head of his father. Immediately took a very big hammer and just smashed the fly. The fly was killed, and the father also killed on the spot. This is what we did. In order, what do we mean? That ours is a secular country. What does it mean? That means we should have equal respect towards all religions. So we should have given in our syllabus teachings, great teachings of all religions. And so that all the children get the basic fundamental teachings, which are nothing different. Every religion speaks of certain values, which are common values. We should have taught them, instead of the what we did, that we killed the fly and we killed the father also. So we removed all types of spiritual education from the education system. No teaching, because ours is a secular country, so we cannot give any spiritual education. If you talk about any spiritual education, immediately they will say, no, ours is a secular country. Don't talk about Gita. Don't talk about Ramayana Mahabharata. No. Remove. I am telling you recently, only last 6 months back, I was in Nagpur, and I was invited by the authorities of engineering college. I go all over the country talking to the students. That is my good pastime. I love talking to the youth. And before the starting of the program, so I was sitting in the, taking a cup of tea with the principal's table. I said, what do you want to tell me? You talk anything minus religion. Because ours is a secular country, and we have been given very clear guidelines by the government of India. There should not be any talk of religion or any such thing. You can talk anything else. I said, I'm going just now. I don't want to remain here, because this dress I have worn only for spreading the Indian spiritual culture, for bringing peace to the mind of the people. Then he became a little, I said, you see, what type of teaching? Then afterwards, when I talked about harmony of religions, interfaith harmony is a must, and we should have equal respect towards all religions and all that. They say, yes, you have talked very, very nice. When are you coming again? I say, I'm not coming to you. Till you say that, yes, spiritual education is a must. But this is, you can tell about, and that college has got very good distinction. It is one of the best colleges in the country. It has got a very good distinction. It is in Nagpur. And that principal, he said, I have returned from this country and got this diploma and this in business, but poor matha khali hai, kuch nahi, gobar hai. He doesn't know what is education. And he became the principal of a big education engineering college. But this is not about him. This is normally there. Most of the people, they do not have idea of what is real education. They do not have ideas. Education is not only the, Swami Vivekananda says, education is not the amount of information that is put into your brain there and runs undigested all your life. Runs riot there, undigested all your life. This is exactly what we are doing. It's a parrot making education. Just go on flooding with the information. Swami Vivekananda told at that time, if information is the education, then it is, libraries are the best educations. Better go to the library full of encyclopedias, full of knowledge, full of information. And now, that time, Swamiji's time, there was no computer, they would have told, go to the Google search, just click and you get all the information. Why do you need to go to the schools and colleges for getting information? And flooding the whole type of information to your brain, vomiting during the examination paper. After the paper, you asked their student, he said, I have vomited, now don't ask. Examination ho gaya, abhi uske bare mat puchna, wo khatam ho gaya. I am not going to schools, college for getting knowledge, not for getting education. I am going only for cramming certain facts which will be vomited during the examination. I will get a degree, with that degree I will get a job, I will get money, and that is the purpose of life. Finish. The buck stops there. So the purpose of life is to earn more money. Why? The more greater the money, the greater the happiness. This equation is there on our mind. And how to get money? By getting good job. How to get the good job? By getting a good certificate. How to get a good certificate? By getting 90%, 92, 91, 93, 93% in the examination. And so all are going by the bad race. This this is the whole situation. So we have got the, we have forgotten the basic purpose of education, whatever it is. So Swami Vivekananda said, what we want is man-making education, character-building education. And then I told Dr. Kalam that in our schools and colleges, we are trying to give this education from last 100 years. Not only that, now we have started various institutions to become resource centers for providing this value education. Value education is the only answer to corruption. There is no other answer because, you know, I gave a beautiful example. They said, what? When I go to the schools and colleges, they said, what, Swamiji, you're coming here to talk about value education and on values of life and on this one. Why don't you go to the ministers? They are the real culprits. They are doing more corruption. Our children are very good. I said, I know it. Your children are good. That is why I come into your children. You know, it is not that we are not talking to the ministers. We try to talk to them because they have got the power. Swami Vivekananda used to meet the kings and princes. He was charged. Why are you going to meet the prince? I said, I can stay with anybody. Sometimes I'm staying in the footpath. I'm staying with the beggar. One day another, I'm staying with the princess. But why are you meeting the prince? I said, if I can impress, influence one prince, then he has got so much of power. All the people in his whole kingdom will get benefit of good education system. That is why I'm trying to influence, and that is why I'm trying to meet. So we also try to meet sometimes. So they will not come as it is. So we invite them for some function, make them chief guest, give a bouquet and all that. And beautiful books and beautiful speech they give. So we thought at least one of them we have converted. But next day newspaper, again his name comes. But we have not left the efforts. We are trying to make paneer out of it. The milk which has been spoiled, we are not throwing away. But I said we are trying to make paneer out of it. We are not throwing away the milk. But the milk which has not been spoiled, this is what we are trying to protect. So we are going to the children. That milk has not been spoiled. Even most of the youth whom I meet, they are full of good ideas. They are idealistic in nature. They want to do something for the nation. They want to do something, but they are not getting guidance, not getting direction. Their parents are telling, follow, 91%, 92%. Parents are telling the same thing. Teachers are saying, homework. Nobody is telling, become an excellent engineer, excellent doctor. Nobody is telling, become an excellent human being. Nobody is telling. Nobody is bothered as to what the children are doing. And the children, they want to do something. But whenever they will try to, they know, don't spoil your time in going for helping the poor or for the trees or for your character building. ये time नहीं है Swami Vivekananda की किताब पढ़ने का. Retirement के बाद पढ़ना, अभी पढ़ो physics, chemistry, mathematics, ये पढ़ो. You know, our value education starts from the home. Charity begins at home. Right from the childhood, first of all, we have told them, what is the purpose of life? Purpose of life is to earn money. That is number one. Second teaching is that, आज के जमाने में पुराना क्या था, पुराना मंत्र था, सत्यमेव जयते, है ना, सत्यमेव जयते. We have taken it from Mundukopanishad. Satyameva jayate nanritam. Satya only will triumph, not untruth. Truth only shall triumph. Satyameva jayate. Truth only shall triumph. And we have, everywhere we have put, that is our national emblem we have put, Satyameva jayate. Under that national emblem only we are doing all types of asatsatya. Isn't it? Satyameva jayate, wo note mein bhi, wo usi ke dwara black money hota hai. सत्यमेव जयते के जहां पर हर एक गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया के लेटर पैड में लिखा रहता है सत्यमेव जयते, उसी लेटर पैड के द्वारा एक्सचेंज होता है सब ब्लैक मार्केटिंग. एंड देन कंपनी का नाम है सत्यम. अभी सत्यम में असत्य होता है तो बाकी असत्यम का क्या हाल होगा? सत्यम का ये हाल है. और आदर्श कॉलोनी इतना आदर्श है तो बाकी जो आदर्श कॉलोनी उसका क्या होगा? नाम भी देखो ये लोग कितना अच्छा अच्छा रखते हैं. दे आर सो वेरी ब्यूटिफुल नेम्स दे आर गिविंग. And we have come a long way. We started with only 10,000 crore rupees of fodder scam. From there, we got Bofors scam, and then 65,000 crores, and then gone. And now 179,000 crore of telecom scam, and now other scams are coming in the pipeline. Every day newspaper, some scam. We are coming a long way. So we are developing very fast in scams. And the amount is increasing. It is not 179,000 crore. 1,79,000 crores, not 1,79,000 only, 1,79,000 crores of scam. So both Rajas are in the jail. I do not know whether they are in jail now, but Raja, ye Raja ka kya haal hai, to Praja ka kya haal hoga? Raja jail mein hai, Praja, jaisa Raja waise Praja, jaisa Praja waise Raja. Yatha Raja, tatha Praja, yatha Praja, tatha Raja. Both are to be blamed, not only Raja, Praja also. Those who are taking bribe are very, very punishable, but those who are giving bribe are also a party to it. Of course, they are excused. What to do? The whole system has become corrupt. So we are a part of the system. So kya kare? Kuch to karna padega. So everybody is telling like that. You know, everybody is telling that what to do. We are a part of the system. And so this is not going to take place. We will not be having corrupt free nation as long as we are thinking that we are helpless creatures of the system. Somebody will have to come forward to give a cup of, to give a bowl of milk. You know the story. Akbar said, Birbal, my courtiers are very nice. Oh, they are very nice. Birbal said, jahan apna gustafi maaf ho, ye sab maska polish karne wale hain. They are all flatterers and I know them. Oh, they can give me life. Woh toh mere liye jaan de sakte hain. They can give whole life for me. Jahan apna gustafi maaf ho, jaan dene ki baat alag hai, ek lota doodh bhi nahi denge. They will not give one bowl of milk. What do you say? Birbal, what do you say? You are insulting my courtiers. Achha, pariksha ho jaye, let us have a test. So the test was performed. Ek hoj banaya gaya. There was a pond that was created. At midnight, every courtier has to put one bowl of milk. Next day morning, they found the whole pond is full of water. Why? Because all the courtiers thought, so many people are going to bring the bowl of milk, and only I am bringing the water. Who is going to see? And it was midnight. So everybody brought water. This is exactly what is happening. We are all thinking, everybody is making money. Everybody is doing corruption. So why should I be left behind? Let me also do. So everybody is contributing to corruption. We are a part of the system. So we are a prey of system. What to do? And so any corruption movement we are going against, we will have to start with ourselves. We cannot become helpless creatures. We will have to start with something. Of course, it requires a lot of sacrifice, lot of courage. It's not a small thing. But somebody will have to stand. Then a critical mass will come. Then there will be transformation. Everything is. I was very happy about when the Lokpal Bill, this movement has started. At least one thing I was very sure. I know that is not going to solve the problem. But one thing is, a great awakening came. That means people have become so much dissatisfied that the whole country stood one. It became one. All the people. That's a very great positive sign. That is, India has not yet gone to sleep. India is still there. Only some sort of ignition is required. Little ignition. It is already there. The inspiration is there. The type of awakening that came when Swami Vivekananda returned from the Western tour in 1897. What an awakening came. The whole country got awakened. Similarly, an awakening came when Gandhiji started non-cooperation movement and the Quit India movement in 1942. And when he got independence, that was a great awakening. All the people joining together in Dandi March, all the people joining together in Quit March. Same type of a glimpse of that awakening we saw during this time, two months back during this. But that's a very good thing. But that is not going to solve the problem. I told Dr. Kalam, you see, we have started resource centers for providing value-oriented education. Ramakrishna Institute of Moral and Spiritual Education, Mysore, Vivekananda Institute of Human Excellence in Hyderabad. So, and now we are going to start Vivekananda Institute of Value Education and Culture, Vivek, in Porbandar. And we would like that you inaugurate that. And he consented, he kept his promise. He came to Porbandar second time again. 13th February 2002, he had come to inaugurate one of the schools. That time he was not the president. He was only Bharat Ratna. But we told that he is not a Bharat Ratna, he is a Vishwa Ratna, he is going to become great. Within 4 months, he became the president of India. Nobody had imagined at that time. There's a long story. I will not talk about it. But then he came on 12 January 2006. I wanted him to come on Swami Vivekananda birthday. You know, Swami Vivekananda birthday celebrated as National Youth Day by our country. So he came on that day and he talked to 5,000 youth. He talked about Swami Vivekananda. He said he is leader not of our nation but the whole world. And he talked how Swami Vivekananda inspired Jamsetji Tata while they were traveling together from Japan to Chicago in a steamer. Swamiji was going to participate in the World Parliament of Religion. Jamsetji Tata was going to see the World Fair. And for steel technology, he wanted to bring some technology. And Swami Vivekananda said, you start Indian Institute of Science. He gave the inspiration, and then later on, Swami Vivekananda, because of the inspiration, Jamsetji Tata started Indian Institute of Science. And he wanted for this project Swami Vivekananda to be the chief patron of that project. But Swamiji was at that time preparing to leave the stage of this world, and he was preparing for his Mahasamadhi. But he put Nivedita, Sister Nivedita, Miss Margaret Noble, who sacrificed his life for the sake her life for the sake of Swami Vivekananda. So Sister Nivedita, and Sister Nivedita came, made Jamsetji Tata and all that, and that's a long story. But anyway, Dr. Kalam told in that public meeting how Jamsetji Tata was inspired by Swami Vivekananda, and then he gave the answers to the questions. Beautiful question answer session, that CD is available. And we have prepared the CD and that we have given many things. Now one of the students stood up and said, sir, Operation Duryodhan, Operation Chakravyuh, and other operations have revealed the tip of the iceberg that is rampant corruption in the country today. As the President of India, how do you feel about it? And where do you think lies the solution? Then Dr. Kalam stood up and said, you see, the Parliament has already taken some actions on the MPs. You know that? And then he took up a book of Swami Vivekananda and he started reading a paragraph where Swami Vivekananda says, no amount of Parliament acts can make a nation good, can make a nation great. Then what can make a nation good and what can make? Again, he read out from Swami Vivekananda book where Swami Vivekananda says, only a large number of good enlightened citizens can make a nation good and can make a nation great. And then he said, and the government cannot produce good people and the government will not produce good people. That also he said. Then who can do it? He said only three persons can do it. Father, mother, and the teacher. Nobody else can do it. So that value education is a must. And so one of the girls says it, as a student, I am a student, how can I contribute to remove corruption from a country? Dr. Kalam said, yes, you can do. You can remove corruption. How? What can I do? I don't have any political power. I cannot stand. I am below 18 years of age. I don't have voting right also. What to talk of standing as a candidate for getting votes? No. You have got very great power. You know, your father has been told by so many people, don't do corruption. But he's not listening. But he will listen to you. Do you love your father? Yes. Your father loves you? Yes. So because your father loves you, if you tell Papa, please don't do it. Papa, please don't do it. I will not take that food which has been obtained by corruption. I will not going to eat that food if you bring that money in my house. If you can stand firm, and remember, if you can stand firm, I am telling you, your father loves you, so he is going to listen to you. He may not listen to anybody's advice, but he will listen to your loving advice. He will listen to your loving request. And your father, how many of you are going to tell your parents, if they are doing corruption, that they don't do corruption? How many? So they all raise their hands. Those, he said, that does not mean, supposing today they are not doing, tomorrow they may do, what will happen? So tomorrow, today they are not doing, but tomorrow if they happen, are you going to protest? Yes. So if all the students, they protest, they are all in the, after all, what is the population? We have got 100 crore people or 120 now, 120 crore people. That means only 30 crores of families or 25 crore families. If all the families, they have got children and all the children are students, and if the students, they say, parents, if they tell their parents, most of the time it is father who is doing, mummy is doing. Of course, she is doing in a small way, but father is doing in a big way. You see, mummy is indirectly responsible. What happens, you know, normally, how the corruption comes? I will tell you what is the root of the problem of corruption. Corruption starts from where? Corruption starts from the family. Now the child, he sees a TV. Papa, 700 rupees ka juta lana hai kal. Ye humne dekha, wo bhi robo. Ye dekha, advertisement, wohi lana hai. Mummy bolti ki nahi, wo to baad mein hoga. Pehle mera ye 3000 wala saadi. Ye maine dekha advertisement mein. Aur mummy ka ek hi shauk hai, shopping. मम्मी शॉपिंग करती है और इसका फिक्स सैलरी है तो 15 दिन में तो हो गया खत्म. नाउ व्हाट टू डू फिर टेबल के नीचे से. सो इनडायरेक्टली मम्मी इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल बिकॉज शी इज सपोर्टिंग द चिल्ड्रन इन गेटिंग द थिंग्स एंड द फेलो इज वर्किंग. प्रीवियसली वॉज वर्किंग 8 hours, नाउ इज वर्किंग 12 hours, देन 15 hours. हाउ मच ही कैन वर्क विद दैट, हाउ मच व्हाइट मनी, हाउ मच ही कैन गेट. सो देन फ्रॉम अंडर द टेबल, सो द करप्शन स्टार्ट्स देयर. सो what is the real root of corruption? That is consumerism. Consumerism is the root of the whole problem. Consumerism, when it comes, then everybody wants to become a crorepati. Sabko ek raat mein, overnight sabko crorepati banna hai. Kaun banega crorepati? Oh, kitna popular ho gaya. Kyon sabko crorepati banna hai? Kaun banega crorepati? Sabko crorepati banna hai. Overnight crorepati banna hai, usme koi galat baat nahi hai. Par kab banna hai? Ek raat mein. सो नेचुरली एक रात में टेबल के नीचे से लेना पड़ेगा. सो द करप्शन स्टार्ट्स देयर, करप्शन स्टार्ट्स देयर. एंड देन द फादर इन द स्कूल ही इज बीइंग टॉट सत्यम वद धर्मम चर. ही इज रिपीटिंग तैतिरीय मंत्रोपनिषद सत्यमेव जयते नानृतम मुंडकोपनिषद. व्हेन ही कम्स टू द होम पापा भाई चुप. ये सब थ्योरिटिकल ठीक है, प्रैक्टिकल लाइफ में बी प्रैक्टिकल. सत्यमेव जयते पुराना मंत्र है, नया मंत्र है असत्यमेव जयते. जितना असत्य का पालन करोगे उतना तुम्हारा उद्धार होगा, नहीं तो तुम पीछे रह जाओगे. सो यू विल बी फॉलन बिहाइंड. गो असत्य का पालन करो. दिस इज व्हाट द पेरेंट्स आर टीचिंग. चैरिटी बिगिंस एट होम एंड करप्शन ऑल्सो बिगिंस एट होम. सो राइट फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग द फादर टेल्स द चाइल्ड, वो बोल दो पापा नहीं है. And then the small child, poor fellow, what does he do? He goes and says, Papa bolte, Papa ghar mein nahi hai. Wo bichara to itna bhola bhala hai, bol deta, Papa bol rahe, Papa nahi hai ghar mein. Ab baad mein Papa ki daant padti hai, are beta, tere ko bola tha, bolna ka tha ki Papa nahi hai, par ye kyon bola ki Papa ne kaha? Bole, aap hi ne to kaha tha, isliye to bola maine. Wo to sach bolna chahta, nahi, sach kabhi mat bolo, jhoot bolo. And when some people, they try to read the books of Swami Vivekananda, they come to the ashram. Their parents say, no, don't go to the ashram, they will spoil you. You know, we are spoiling them. So they give it a good training. No, be practical. Don't be idealist, be practical. Be practical means there is a flock of sheep, all are doing for corruption, all are going for black money, all are going for hard money, all are going for instant, becoming instant crorepati. So you follow that trend. And don't follow honesty, truthfulness. These are all old mantras. New mantra is asatyamev jayate. This is what he's teaching. So he's one particular father in Bombay, he stopped, he told his son not to go to our Swamiji. So our Swamiji, okay, don't go. After some time, he met that father. He was very miserable. Okay, how are you? Now your son is not coming to me, so are you happy? Bole, kya batau Swamiji, us to mere pickpocket shuru kiya. Bole, aap hi ne usko sikhaya, beta. आज के जमाने में सत्य बनी बोलना चाहिए, झूठ बोलना चाहिए, जैसा सब लोग ब्लैक मार्केटिंग करना चाहिए. तो और तुम भी ब्लैक मार्केटिंग करते हो, उसने देखा है काला बाजार को, उसने बोला तुम बड़े चोर हो, तो बोले मैं छोटा चोर बन के बोलू, बाप से तो सवाया बेटा होना चाहिए, तो पहले बाप का ही पॉकेट मारू. तो उसने पॉकेट मारना शुरू किया, बाप क्या पॉकेट. बोले आप ही ने तो मुझे सिखाया सच कभी मत बोलो, तो मैं झूठ बोल रहा हूं. तो पहला झूठ बोलना शुरू किया पापा से, पापा ने ट्रेनिंग दिया था झूठ बोलने का. तो इसने ही स्टार्टेड एक्सपेरिमेंटिंग विद हिज फादर. यू नो गांधी जी रोट ए बुक माई एक्सपेरिमेंट विद ट्रूथ, एंड हियर नाउ द चिल्ड्रन स्टार्टेड रीडिंग, स्टार्टेड दे विल राइट द बुक माई एक्सपेरिमेंट विद अनट्रूथ, दे विल राइट बिकॉज दिस इज हाउ दे वर टॉट. दिस इज हाउ द करप्शन स्टार्ट्स. चैरिटी बिगिंस एट होम, द करप्शन स्टार्ट्स एट होम. वी आर ऑल पार्टीज ऑफ दैट करप्शन. सो स्वामी विवेकानंद सेज no amount of parliament acts can make a nation good, can make a nation great. Only large number of good enlightened citizens can make a nation good, can make a nation great. It's a very long process. So we have to have transformation of our own lives. Be and make. First of all, you become great, then make others great. Build your own character, then make others' character. This is the only process. It's a long-run process. And we have to start from where we are. At present, the system is very, very corrupt system. I know, you will tell Swamiji, it is very easy to say, follow the values, this and that, but now it is not practicable. I said, yes, it is very difficult, number one. It's very difficult, but it is possible. Because we are also surviving in the same society. We have to face very great hardships. For a small work, we have purchased the land. We have purchased the land. We have given the whole amount in white. We have got registered document. Now if we go to the government to transfer it in my name, mutation, when I went to Ranchi, the additional collector point blank told me, you have to give the bribe. I said, what do you mean? Ours is Ramakrishna Mission. It started by Swami Vivekananda. Every paisa is accounted for. That is why even in West Bengal, so long there was the red fault was there, you know, communist. So whole year they would go on criticizing Ramakrishna Mission. But any disaster, again, they would approach Ramakrishna Mission for doing relief work. Why? Because they know if they give 1 lakh rupee to Ramakrishna Mission, 99 lakh rupees they will bring donation and it will be 1 crore rupees of worth of relief work. And if they give 1 lakh rupees to any other NGO, there will be 10,000 rupees of this relief work. Rest 90,000 will go in getting the paper, photograph printed and all that, on publicity and all that, or in the pocket of somebody. So they know it very well. I said, because of the transparency of last 120 years, Ramakrishna surviving, and we can never give a single paisa like that. So we will not give the bribe. Then he said, what did he say? You see, Swamiji, we know you are doing very good services, not that we do not know. That is why we are making special concession for you. There are so many other institutions, Christian missionary, tam logo ko kitna deti hai. Aap log ka itna Hindu sansta hai, itna acha kaam kar rahe tribal ke liye, isliye aap log ko bahut concession kar diya. But we will not leave you. So that is why they gave me the label Sukha Party. Sukha Party aa gaya. Then when I went to Patna, they said, Swamiji, yahan ye aapka sab lecture baji nahi chalega, yahan to cash mein baat hota hai. Aap pehle rupya rakhiye, pehle bribe dijiye, uske baad mein aapki baat sunenge. Nahi hoga. Bole, hum to bribe de hi nahi sakte hain. Bole, to aapka kaam nahi hoga. Bada mushkil. 2-3 days I went. Pehle bribe, this is Bihar. Ye Bihar, wah, pehle rupya dijiye, uske baad mein kaam hoega. Like they started. Then I said, okay. कल मैं लाऊंगा ब्राइब लाऊंगा देन दे हैव चलो स्वामी जी को कन्वर्ट किया मैं बोला चलो नहीं है तीन दिन से आ रहा है कुछ काम नहीं हो रहा है देन आई वेंट नेक्स्ट डे आई टुक ब्यूटीफुल फोटो ब्यूटीफुल बुक्स ऑफ स्वामी विवेकानंद ऐसे ये लाया हाँ ये कोई ये ब्राइब है इससे हम क्या करेगा खाएगा अरे ये बच्चे के लिए देना बहुत अच्छा स्टोरी है इसमें आपका बच्चा खुश हो जाएगा ओह उससे इतना अच्छा स्टोरी है बहुत खुश हो जाएगा अरे इसको हम क्या खाएगा देन नेक्स्ट डे This why I gave to Bada Babu. Then the dealing clerk says, अच्छा आप बड़ा बाबू को किताब दिया हमारा बच्चा नहीं कहता हमको किताब का ही नहीं दिया नहीं तुम्हारे भी लाएगा अगेन आई ब्रॉट बुक्स फॉर हिम देन अदर पर्सन सेड आप उन लोगों के लिए आया हमारा फाइल हमारे पास आने वाला है आपके आपके लिए भी लाएगा होल रेवेन्यू डिपार्टमेंट आई ब्रॉट सम बुक्स ऑफ स्वामी जी विद द परमिशन ऑफ हेडक्वार्टर दैट इज ओनली ब्राइब आई हैव पेड आई सेड इफ आई डू नॉट गेट द लैंड डजेंट मैटर एटलीस्ट स्वामी जी का मैसेज तो चला गया ये कभी ना कभी काम करेगा देखो बिहार चेंज हो रहा है वो किताब गया तो कुछ ना चेंज हो रहा है सो स्वामी जी बुक आर डेंजरस अन्ना हजारे रीड इट एंड ही वॉज सेव्ड फ्रॉम सुसाइड देर आर सो मेनी द बुक्स आर सो पावरफुल स्वामी जी बुक्स आर सो पावरफुल इट इज गोइंग टू क्रिएट अ चेंज टूडे और टुमारो इवन वन सेंटेंस कैन मेक समबडीज लाइफ That is why Romarola says about Swami, books of Swami Vivekananda, his books, his words are great music, phrases in the style of Vidovan. I cannot touch these sayings of his scattered as they are through the pages at a 30th distance without receiving a thrill through my body like an electric shock. So that powerful books are there. Now this is the only way what we can contribute. Now let us now conclude. Already I have taken much more time, only 3 minutes more. So now number one. Value of values in life. Money is very valuable. Gold is very valuable. But you cannot eat money. You cannot eat gold. And not only that, the life, human life is meant for realizing the ultimate reality. The goal of human life is to manifest this divinity within by controlling nature, external and internal. Do this either by work, worship, psychic control, philosophy, by one or more or all of these, and be free. This is the whole of religion. Dogmas, rituals, worship, temples, churches, mosques are but secondary details. This is what Swami Vivekananda says in book on Raja Yoga. So the purpose of life is to manifest the divinity, and that will give us infinite joy, infinite happiness, infinite bliss. And that is Satya. If you want to realize the truth, you have to pay the price for it. And what is the return you are getting? Infinite joy, infinite happiness, infinite bliss. And what is the price you have to pay is only for a short time. Only for a short time. By practicing truth, what you will get? You will get Param Satya. Param Satya means infinite joy, infinite happiness, infinite reality. You will realize the truth. So that is why Gandhiji said, not that God is truth, truth is God. Satya hi Parameshwar hai. Good truth itself is God. That is what Gandhiji said. He experimented in his own life. He has. So if you follow the truth, what is the reality you'll get? It's criticism. First thing you will get, Ojo Harishchandra Puchudu Ayu. They will start criticizing you that here is the tale of Harishchandra. They will criticize you, don't worry. But ultimately, what you will get? Maximum you will get a bullet. But Gandhiji, he practiced truth, he got a bullet. And when survey was carried out a few years back, the greatest personality of the whole world, you know who was he? Mahatma Gandhi. So, this is the sacrifice he paid. He followed the truth. It appeared that the truth got defeated because he got a bullet in the chest. But he became immortal. Is he died? No. Today also he is alive. So, if we practice truth, if we practice honesty, if we practice values in our life, maybe for the time being it appears that we are losing. We are losing in terms of money. But one thing you will get, that is peace of mind, which is a rare commodity. If you want peace of mind, we want to be, our conscience to be clear, we have to follow the values. This is the price we have to pay. There are two paths. One, follow the herd of sheep, go after sheep, one sheep after another, go after materialism, go after consumerism, go after asatya meva jayate, go after corruption, go after black money. Get lot of money, beautiful car, beautiful bungalow, and no peace of mind. And then commit suicide. This is one path. Committing suicide does not mean literally committing suicide, but when you are not having happiness and you are having frustration and devotion, that is more than committing suicide. Second path is path of struggle, trying to follow the values in a society which is full of, bereft of all the values. In the present scenario, very difficult to practice values in the society today, particularly in India. But stick to your guns, try to practice it. Whatever, I will be very practical. Sri Ramakrishna followed truth. He said, Satya Kali Yug ki tapasya hai. He said, truth, following truth is the real tapasya for the modern age. Meaning thereby, number two, it is the most difficult thing. In the previous time, they used to do hard tapasya, standing on one leg for thousands of years. That type of tapasya, no food, that is tapasya, olden times. He said, but this is more difficult than that. Speaking the truth, following the truth is more difficult than that tapasya. And the reward also will be much more than what you got that by tapasya. But speaking the truth is very, so Sri Ramakrishna practiced it. His father practiced it, that is why he got God. Khudiram Chattopadhyay was, you know, a very good Brahmin, and he never compromised with truth. And he was such a nice person. The landlord of that village, the name of the village is Dere, about 80 miles from Calcutta. I'm talking about more than about 250 years. That time Dere Gaon, that particular person, Khudiram Chattopadhyay. And then the Jamidar, the landlord, was in trouble. So all of them suggested, if Khudiram gives witness in your favor, you will win the case. So Khudiram was brought. He said, I cannot lie. I will not give a false witness. Then the landlord said, do you know the price you have to pay? You don't know. He said, I know. But I will not. I have never spoken a lie and I will never speak a lie. What is the price you have to pay, you know? He was thrown out. His goods were thrown out. He was thrown out from the village. Then he came to the village Kamarpukur, nearby village. And then one of his friends gave a little bit of land. And there somehow, with great poverty, he was staying. He had not 2 meals, sometimes only 1 meal. but he was satisfied, he was worshipping. And then he went to Gaya for finishing some rites. Night he got the vision. Gadadhar Vishnu Bhagwan gave the dream, and he said, Gadadhar Vishnu said, Khudiram, I am so happy seeing you are sticking to the truth and so happy with your devotion. I will be born as your son. You can imagine how happy a person would be. God coming in the form of his son. But Khudiram said, no, please do not come. He said, I am poor, how will I feed you? I do not have butter, nothing. I am not getting food myself. How will I feed you? So please don't come to my house. Then the Lord smiled and said, don't worry about my food. Whatever little you will give, I will be satisfied. But I am so much satisfied by your truthfulness, I will come to you. So if you follow the truth, you may not get money. You may be thrown out, but God will come to you. That is the return you will get by following truth. And we have to sacrifice for that. So this is what happens. Sri Ramakrishna practiced truth. But now it's very difficult to follow. Over the years it has become very difficult. But Sri Ramakrishna says, I have done 100%, you may do 1%. Doesn't matter. Do something. Start with something. Last incident, Holy Mother Sharda Devi. She was the consort of Sri Ramakrishna. One person wrote that, I have read the Gospel of Sri Ramakrishna, where Sri Ramakrishna, every page he is telling, follow the truth, please speak the truth, speak the truth, and his life is ennobling. And when I am working here, in this particular job that I am doing, I have to speak a lie. Because all my subordinates, all my colleagues, and all my bosses, they are all speaking a lie. And so they tell me that you have to speak a lie. So I have to do the wrong thing. And my conscience is biting. So I am thinking of resigning from the job. Please advise me. Should I give up the job or not? Now, Sharda Devi at that time, you know, she was a simple village woman, but she was a great administrator. Whole Ramakrishna mission she was running. So she was cutting at that time, dressing the vegetables, and she used to give, you know, she knew time management. So she is dressing the vegetables, at the same time somebody is reading out the letters, and she will dictate the letters. So the one brahmachari read out the letter. So what reply I should give? Sharda Devi said, tell him not to resign. And he was bewildered. What? You are consort of Sri Ramakrishna, you are also following the truth, and that fellow wants to follow the truth, wants to follow in the footsteps of Sri Ramakrishna, and you are telling not to. I am telling you, write down, don't resign. He was still not. Should I write? Yes, write down. Then he was very much perplexed. He said, why are you telling like that? Then Holy Mother very gravely said, you know, today he is feeling guilty conscious. He is feeling guilty conscious that he has to speak a lie. And that is why he wants to resign a post. When he will become jobless, at that time he will have his wife and children, there will be no food. He will not hesitate in stealing the property of others at that time. I want to save him from that greater sin. So he said, let him go on finding some better job. When he gets a better job where he has not to speak a lie, then only resign. She was so practical. So we have to be very practical without compromising with the ideal. But sometimes we have to compromise with the ideal, knowing full well we can pray to God, O Lord, please grant us. In the present circumstances, it's not possible for me to follow the truth, to follow the values 100%. Plus, give me the strength, and God will give the strength. So let us pray. Already my time is up. I pray to the Lord that he may give us the strength to follow values in life, the spiritual and moral values, moral values of unselfishness, truth, honesty, to the extent possible. In the present scenario, it is very difficult. But if we individually follow, if we start pouring our milk into the pond, by seeing me, somebody else will be promoted. One lamp we will light. Then from one lamp to another lamp, jyot se jyot jale, and then there will be critical mass, and the whole nation will be free from corruption. Thank you very much.
So friends, on behalf of all of you and Ahmedabad Management Association, we must thank Swamiji for value in the everyday's life that the inspiring lecture that he has given for more than 1.5 hours, and he has given many take-home tips, and I'm confident that many of you would like to follow the same. As I said in the beginning, tomorrow evening also you are welcome for his lecture on Swami Vivekananda, a global leader for global civilization. Please, all of you are most welcome. Thank you all.